Truth MJB. Welcome. How the rulers control the imaginations of the public through the principles of mental gender. The principle of mental gender gives the truth underlying the whole field of the phenomena of mental influence. The tendency of the feminine principle is always in the direction of receiving impressions, while the tendency of the masculine principle is always in the direction of giving out or expressing. The feminine principle has much more varied field of operation than has the masculine principle. The feminine principle conducts the work of generating new thoughts, concepts, ideas, including the work of the imagination. The masculine principle contents itself with the work of the will in its varied phases. And yet, without the active aid of the will of the masculine principle, the feminine principle is apt to rest content with generating mental images which are the result of impressions received from outside, instead of producing original mental creations. Persons who can give continued attention and thought to a subject, actively employ both of the mental principles, the feminine in the work of the mental generation, and the masculine, will in stimulating and energizing the creative portion of the mind. The majority of persons really employ the masculine principle but little, and are content to live according to the thoughts and ideas instilled into the me from the eye of other minds. But it is not our purpose to dwell upon this phase in this video. Anyone into psychic phenomena is aware of the wonderful phenomena classified under the head of telepathy, thought transference, mental influence, suggestion, hypnotism, etc. Many have sought for an explanation of these varied phases of phenomena under the theories of the various dual mind teachers. And in a measure they are right, for there is clearly a manifestation of two distinct phases of mental activity. But if such persons will consider these dual minds in the light of the Hermetic teachings regarding vibrations and mental gender, they will see that the long sought for key is at hand. In the phenomena of telepathy, it is seen how the vibratory energy of the masculine principle is projected toward the feminine principle of another person, and the latter takes the seed thought and allows it to develop into maturity. In the same way, suggestion and hypnotism operates. The masculine principle of the person giving the suggestions directs a stream of vibratory energy or willpower toward the feminine principle of the other person, and the latter accepting it makes it its own and acts and thinks accordingly. An idea thus lodged in the mind of another person grows and develops, and in time is regarded as the rightful mental offspring of the individual, whereas it is in reality like the cuckoo egg placed in the sparrow's nest, where it destroys the rightful offspring and makes itself at home. The normal method is for the masculine and feminine principles in a person's mind to coordinate and act harmoniously in conjunction with each other, but, unfortunately, the masculine principle in the average person is too lazy to act. The display of willpower is too slight. And the consequence is that such persons are ruled almost entirely by the minds and wills of other persons, whom they allow to do their thinking and willing for them. Stop allowing others to think for you. Do your thinking, yourself. How few original thoughts or original actions are performed by the average person. The majority of persons are mere shadows and echoes of others, having stronger wills or minds than themselves. The trouble is that the average person dwells almost altogether in his me consciousness and does not realize that he has such a thing as an I. He is polarized in his feminine principle of mind, and the masculine principle, in which is lodged the will, is allowed to remain inactive and not employed. The strong men and women of the world invariably manifest the masculine principle of will, and their strength depends materially upon this fact. Instead of living upon the impressions made upon their minds by others, they dominate their own minds by their will, obtaining the kind of mental images desired, and moreover dominate the minds of others likewise, in the same manner. Look at the strong people, how they manage to implant their seed thoughts in the minds of the masses of the people, thus causing the latter to think thoughts in accordance with the desires and wills of the strong individuals. This is why the masses of people are such sheep-like creatures, never originating an idea of their own, nor using their own powers of mental activity. The manifestation of mental gender may be noticed all around us in everyday life. The magnetic persons are those who are able to use the masculine principle in the way of impressing their ideas upon imaginations of others. They are the rulers of humanity. Let's stop here for today. Thank you. If you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, and subscribe.